Very, very happy to have all of you. It's a beautiful Sunday morning and we have a big festival here today, Festival of Deities. Subhara Prabhu and Shilpa Mataji are inviting Gaurangita Deities to their home. And what a start to today's day by having a class from His Grace Gauranga Darshan Prabhu. So Gauranga Darshan Prabhu has joined. Let's wait for Prabhu to be ready. And we can hear Bhagavad Katha from Prabhu. I humbly request everyone to keep your phones on mute while you're not speaking. It's easy for you to deliver the lecture without any disturbance. And to whoever possible, put on your videos so it will be more personal interaction for Prabhu. Hare Krishna Prabhuji, please let me know whenever you're ready for me.
Hare Krishna,
let us all welcome His Grace Gauranga Darshan Prabhu. Three loud and clear. Hari Bol.
Hari Bol. Hari Bol.
Hari Bol. Hari Bol.
Prabhuji, please accept our humble senses. We are very grateful that you are giving your time in your busy schedule. So many services. I'm sure this is like an added, not a trouble, but a service, you know, that you are extending yourself. We are very, very grateful, Prabhuji. I mean, I don't know how else to express. Actually, to call senior Vaishnavas like you, Your Grace, to our small satsang here, sometimes I feel very unqualified. But somehow, it's my audacity that I just go ahead and approach you all, and you are accepting so mercifully, Prabhuji. Very, very grateful, Prabhuji. Please tell us whatever we have to hear from you. From Srimad Bhagavatam, we are ready for it.
Thank you so much, Leelanand Prabhu. Dando Pranam. I am currently in Vrindavan. Very happy to meet all of you devotees from Vrindavan Dham. So, as per your request, I would be speaking something that inspires us to study Prabhupada books. That's what you wanted, right? So anything that is inspiring to read Prabhupada's books and distribute Prabhupada's books. So I will try to speak whatever little bit I know from reading Prabhupada's books only. So we will begin. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Hare Krishna. I welcome all the devotees for this small session about the importance of reading Prabhupada's books. So, of all the books that Vyasadeva has written, the book Srimad Bhagavatam is very special and unique. Because Srimad Bhagavatam is that kind of literature that has given satisfaction to even its author, Vyasadeva. So an inspiration to study Bhagavatam comes from understanding Bhagavatam's glory and also comes from understanding the relevance of Bhagavatam in one's own life. So, and another point is to the degree we relish Bhagavatam, to the degree we understand the importance of Bhagavatam, to that degree we can spread the message of Bhagavatam to others. So one need to have a personal conviction that this Bhagavatam is very beneficial to me and to the entire humanity. So then one will be able to study Bhagavatam nicely and also spread the message of Bhagavatam to others. So those who happen to be involved in spreading the message of Bhagavatam are actually specially blessed by Krishna. In fact, they are taking up a great responsibility. So whoever is involved in book distribution or distributing what is there inside the book. Book distribution is of two types. One is distributing the book itself. Second is distributing the message which is inside the book. That is the whole preaching effort in various forms, in whichever form that people can relate to. So such people are called the most benevolent benefactors of the human society. Those are spreading the knowledge of the scriptures. So who are the greatest benefactors? There are different opinions. But let's see the opinion of the gopis of Vrindavan. So 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam is considered the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. It's the most important section of Srimad Bhagavatam. And within the 10th canto, the Rasa Panchadhyaya, the five chapters where Krishna's Rasa Leela is glorified, that's even more special and unique. Well, the 10th canto is compared with the beautiful face of Krishna. This five chapters, Rasa Panchadhyaya, like a nice smile on Krishna. So in the middle of Rasa Panchadhyaya, Rasa Panchadhyaya has five chapters. In the middle, that is 31st chapter, we have Gopi Gita. And Gopi Gita has 19 shlokas. And in the middle of the Gopi Gita, in the 9th shloka, the gopis of Vrindavan are saying, Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam kavibhiridhitam kalmashaham shravanam shrimadatatam bhuvigranantiye bhuridajana Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam. Tava kathamritam means the nectarian katha of Krishna. Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam kavi bhiriditam. The nectar of Krishna's words or nectar of words that are glorifying Krishna. Okay, means Krishna katha basically. Katha done by Krishna or katha about Krishna, whatever. So that Krishna katha is the real relief for people who are suffering in this world. Tapta jivanam kavi bhiriditam kalmashapaham kavibhir iditam. So that Krishna katha is spoken so expertly and enthusiastically by great kavis, very expert devotees. And kalmashapaham, that Krishna katha can completely destroy the kalmashas or contamination in the hearts of people. Shravana mangalam srimadatatam. Shravana mangalam, hearing that Srimad Bhagavatam is mangalam, it's all auspicious, right? Srimad Atatam, and these glories of Krishna Katha are broadcast by several devotees. They have such Srimad, means they are filled with spiritual power, and they are broadcast all over the world by great devotees. And whoever is broadcasting this Krishna Katha all over the world is Bhurida Janaha. Bhuvi Grinantiye Bhurida Janaha. Bhurida Janaha means most benevolent personality, most munificent personality. The greatest mercy or compassion that one can show on common people is by providing them a way and means to come in contact with Krishna through Krishna Katha. So we can re-establish our connection with Krishna through Krishna Katha, right? So those who preach Krishna Katha are really special souls. And for that, one need to nourish oneself with Krishna Katha first. So without we personally relishing Krishna Katha, we can't share Krishna Katha, as simple as that. So one can chant nicely, can speak about the holy names. Yesterday in Vrindavan, we were attending the Bhagavatam class of His Holiness Sachinandan Maharaj. So Maharaj was so beautifully sharing some nectar about Hulini. So Maharaj said, just imagine, Krishna is personally watching you while you're chanting. Maharaj made a point. He just asked a question to the audience. He said that, what if Krishna and His Holiness were not different? When we hear this, Nama Chintamani Krishna, Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha, Purna Shuddho Nitya Mukto Abhinnatva Nama Naminaha. Nama and Nami are Abhinna. There is no difference between the name and the possessor of the name. We hear that in classes, Bhagavatam classes, we read that in books. But outside the class, outside the book reading session, how much are we remembering it? And how much are we demonstrating that understanding? So just imagine, Maharaj is saying, just imagine what difference would it make to your life if Krishna's name is not different from Krishna? Okay. And Maharaj also said that, like, if Prabhupada is watching your chanting, how attentively would you be chanting? So like that, because Maharaj has invested so much of his time and energy and enthusiasm and heart and love in chanting the holy names. When he speaks about the holy name, about the whole process of chanting, that impacts the hearts of the hearers. Right? Similarly, when we have to spread the message of Srimad Bhagavatam, when we have to do book distribution or distributing what is there inside the book, we need to personally study first. So when we study Srimad Bhagavatam and when we are able to relish Bhagavatam, then we can even share the message of Bhagavatam. So there is a beautiful shloka in the third canto of Bhagavatam. Vidura says this to Maitreya. Tadasya kausharava sharmadatur harih kathameva kathasusaram udhrutya pushpebhya ivartabandho शिवायनः कीर्तयतीर्थ कीर्तेः तदस्य कौशारव शर्मदातुर् ओ कौशारव मुनि ओ मैत्रेय मुनि यू आर शर्मदातु यू आर द बेस्टोवर ऑफ ग्रेट ऑस्पिशियसनेस शर्मदातुर् हरेः कथामेव कथा सुसारम प्लीज बेस्टो ऑस्पिशियसनेस अपॉन अस बाय स्पीकिंग द एसेंस ऑफ ऑल कथास दैट इज कृष्ण कथा हरेः कथामेव कथा सुसारम. There are so many kathas, the sara, the essence of all kathas is harikatha. Udhrutya pushpebhya eva artha bandho, oh friend of distressed people. Just like a honeybee goes to different places, different flowers and gardens and collects the essence which is honey. Similarly, you speak the essential topic of harikatha more than anything else. So this is the request of Vidura to Maitreya. So Harikatha is the essence of all kathas, and that Harikatha is so wonderfully mentioned, described elaborately in Srimad Bhagavatam. Right? By hearing that Srimad Bhagavatam, whatever is anartha, whatever is meaningless, whatever is useless in our life will be removed.
Anarthopashamam sakshad bhakti yoga madhokshajim लोकस्य अजनतो विद्वांश्चक्रे सात्वत संहितं अनर्थ उपशमं साक्षात.
So that what can mitigate the miseries of material existence, what can release all of us from anarthas or unwanted things in this world, that is bhakti yoga. And to propound that bhakti yoga, Vyasadeva has written Srimad Bhagavatam. People don't know that it's bhakti yoga that relieves them from all material miseries and anarthas. Bhakti yoga madhokshaje lokasya ajanato vidvams. Common people don't know this. Chakre satvata samhitam. So that's why Vyasadeva has written this Srimad Bhagavatam. So this Srimad Bhagavatam is considered one's friend and one's companion. Madeka bandho matsangin madguro man mahadhana mannistaraka madbhagya madananda namostute. Madeka bandho, Bhagavatam is my only relative. Matsangin, भागवत में इज माई कंपेनियन, मत गुरु भागवत में इज माई
टीचर,
मन महाधन भागवत में इज माई ग्रेटेस्ट ट्रेजर, मन निस्तारक भागवत में इज माई डिलीवरर, भागवत में लिबरेट्स मी, ओके, मत भाग्य इज माई ग्रेटेस्ट फॉर्चून टू स्टडी भागवत, हियर भागवतम, मद आनंद नमोस्तुते, एंड भागवतम इज द कॉज ऑफ माई ग्रेटेस्ट प्लेजर. सो इन दिस वे भागवतम इज ग्लोरिफाइड बाय सनातन गोस्वामी. सो वी नीड टू सी दैट बाय स्टडीइंग श्रीमद् भागवतम एंड बाय हियरिंग श्रीमद् भागवतम इन द एसोसिएशन ऑफ डिवोटीज देयर इज अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ हार्ट दैट वी एक्सपीरियंस एंड टू द डिग्री we nourish ourselves in that association of devotees by studying, by hearing, discussing Krishna Katha, to that degree we can spread this culture to others also. So even after doing tapasya and even after directly personally seeing the beautiful form of the Lord, several pure devotees like Dhruva Maharaj, Prithu Maharaj, then Prachetas, then Lord Shiva, Prahlad Maharaj, all these exalted devotees are aspiring for this benediction only. The topmost aspiration of any Vaishnava is to associate with devotees and discuss Harikatha. What did Dhruva say after seeing the Supreme Lord directly? Dhruva Maharaj said, happiness can be attained only in two ways. One is tava pada padma dhyanat, by meditating on the lotus feet of the Lord. Second is bhavajjana katha sravanena vasyat, by hearing Krishna katha in the association of devotees. This is the aspiration of Dhruva after seeing the Lord. Okay, Dhruva could have asked hundreds different things, but Dhruva is asking only one thing, that is association of devotees so that they can hear Krishna katha in that association. Okay, in the next shloka Dhruva says that भक्तिं मुहुः प्रवहतां त्वयि मे प्रसंगो भूयादनन्त महतां अमलाशयानां येनाञ्जसोल्बणमुरुव्यसनं भवाब्धिं नेष्ये भवद्गुणकथामृतपानमत्तः भक्तिं मुहुः प्रवहतां त्वयि मे त्वयि मे प्रसंगो. Dhruva says, O Lord, if you are merciful upon me, please give me the opportunity to associate with your devotees, right? Toime prasango, and why they are so great? Bhuyat ananta mahatam, they have unlimited glory, greatness. Amalashayanam, their ashayas, their aspirations are very pure. They don't have any material aspirations. They have pure aspirations to serve the Lord. So when I also associate with those people who are pure in their aspirations, I will also develop such pure aspirations, right? So, even Krishna Katha, outside the association of devotees, even study of Srimad Bhagavatam, without the association of devotees, is not that effective in comparison to studying and hearing Bhagavatam in the association of devotees. Right? Because one may not be able to maintain one's spirit, one may not be able to maintain one's enthusiasm and commitment to the whole process of hearing Harikatha and studying Srimad Bhagavatam without company of devotees, like-minded devotees, right? So Bhagavatam is best relished in the association of devotees. Bhakti is best practiced in the association of devotees. So now this shloka, bhaktim muhuh pravahatam toyime prasango bhuyad ananta mahatam avalashayanam. Ananta mahatam means the devotees are unlimitedly powerful. Amalashayana, their aspirations are very pure. Yenanja solpana guru vyasanam bhavadhim neshye bhavad guna kathamrta panamattah. I will be able to cross over this material existence very easily, very effortlessly, by taking shelter of the devotees and hearing Krishna katha from them. Because it is the sound vibration of Srimad Bhagavatam that is emanating from the lotus lips of a devotee that purifies our contaminated aspirations. There is another shloka that says this. The shloka says that pibanti ye bhagavata atmanasatam kathamrutam shravana puteshu sambhritam punanti te vishaya vidoshitashayam vrajanti tacharana sarvaruhantikam pibanti ye bhagavata atmanasatam. Pibanti means drinking. Okay. Pibanti ye bhagavata atmanasatam. One who hears Srimad Bhagavatam. Basically, one who drinks Srimad Bhagavatam through ear holes. Generally, one drinks through mouth. But this nectar of Bhagavatam is drunk through ear holes. At kathamrutam shravana puteshu samhrutam. The kathamruta, the nectarian katha of Krishna, is drunk through the ear holes. Shravana puteshu samhrutam. And by doing so, what will happen? Punanti te vishaya vidushita ashayam. Our ashayas, our aspirations, our goals, our desires are contaminated by desires for sense enjoyment. Vishaya vidushita ashayam. Okay. Vishaya vidushita ashayam means the aspirations are contaminated by desires for sense enjoyment. Punantiti. Such aspirations are purified by developing, by hearing Krishna Katha, by hearing Bhagavatam. What happens is, one will understand one's own real identity as servants of Krishna, as eternal servants of Krishna. So once I understand that I am not the body and I am a soul, and the soul's identity is to be a servant of Krishna, next question is, what are my activities as soul? Like many people, spiritualists, they may just stop at this stage. I am not body, I am soul. Right? I need to realize that I am a soul. Fine. You understand you are a soul. But what are your activities as soul? What should you do? Being a soul, eternal part and parcel of Krishna, what exactly is your activity? And that's what a devotee, that's the activity of a devotee. So once you understand your identity as servant of Krishna, what are the specific services that I can render to Krishna? That's what we need to understand. And Bhakti Yoga begins with that. So Bhakti Yoga is a set of so many activities that are pleasing to Krishna. Okay, not just understanding oneself as soul, but also knowing what are the activities of soul, of a pure living entity, of a pure Amsha of Krishna and pure servant of Krishna, what am I supposed to do? And that is Bhakti Yoga. So, what a soul is supposed to do? A soul is meant to be engaging one's subtle body and gross body in Krishna's service. A soul, a conditioned soul, I'm speaking in the context of all of us only. So, a conditioned soul who is entrapped in this gross and subtle material bodies will be able to come out of this entanglement of this gross and subtle material bodies and realize one's real spiritual identity as servant of Krishna to the degree one engages the gross and subtle bodies in the service of Krishna. And that is sadhana bhakti. Okay. So, now a devotee engages one's body in various services of Krishna. A devotee engages one's intelligence in understanding the glories of Krishna and studying Shastra. And a devotee engages one's mind in thinking of Krishna, in thinking of, in remembering Krishna's Nama, Rupa, Guna, Lila. So that's how a devotee spends his time. Jihve kirtaya keshavam muraripum चेतो भज श्रीधरम पाणि द्वंद्व समर्चयाच्युत कथा श्रोत्र द्वयत्वं श्रुणु कृष्णं लोकय लोचन द्वय हरेर गच्छांघ्र युग्मालयम् जिघ्र घ्राण मुकुंद पाद तुलसीम मूर्धन्य माधोक्षजम् जिह्वे कीर्तय Keshavam. A devotee engages one's tongue in glorifying Krishna. Muraripum Cheto Bhaja. A devotee engages one's mind in thinking of Krishna. Cheto Bhaja Sridharam Panidvandva Samarchaya. With one's two hands, a devotee worships the Lord. Right? Achyuta Kathaha Shrutta Dvaitam Shrunu. With one's two ears, one should hear Krishna Katha. Right? So Krishnam Lokaya Lochana Dvaya Hare. With one's two eyes, one should see the beautiful form of Krishna, the deity form of Krishna. Gachhanghari Yugmalayam. And with two legs, one should walk to the temple of Krishna. So in this way, and one, with nostrils, one should smell the tulsi leaves offered to the lotus feet of Krishna. So in this way, by engaging one's subtle body and gross body in Krishna's service, one will be able to revive one's original identity as servant of Krishna. And after realizing that original identity as Krishna's servant, what is one supposed to do? Same thing. Same. Engaging all one's body, mind and senses in Krishna's service. But in that realized state, in that liberated state, there is no difference between body and soul. Everything becomes one. Right? Now there is a difference between the soul and the gross material body outside. But when somebody realizes one's spiritual identity, there is no difference between body and soul. They're one. Right? So there is no soul inside Vaikuntha Vasi, which is different from the body. So the soul, body, both are same. Okay. There's no need of Paramatma also inside. Here it all, everything is needed. There's no Paramatma in the spiritual world. Okay. No need of Paramatma. Of course, the Lord is the source of Paramatma. Bhagavan is everywhere. So now, where do we get this understanding? It is from the scriptures. Okay. It is from Prabhupada's books. So Srila Prabhupada has given this rich wisdom, rich knowledge of scriptures in a language that is understandable by the modern world. That's the speciality of Prabhupada. So he has put all the scriptures in a form that is more accessible to the modern world and more understandable and relatable to the modern world. The kind of purports that Prabhupada writes are very much relevant for the modern context. The kind of examples that he uses in his purports. Right? So when we are studying Srila Prabhupada's books, we are associating with Prabhupada. We are with Prabhupada. So one may not get an opportunity, one may not have got the opportunity to personally see Prabhupada, personally be with Prabhupada, but one can do so by studying his books. Okay. So, in fact, we are associating with Prabhupada by studying Bhaktivedanta purports. We are associating with Dhruva by reading his story. We are associating with Parikshit Maharaj by reading his pastimes in Bhagavatam. So, Bhagavatam contains the descriptions of several exalted devotees. And by studying their stories and analyzing their characteristics and learning what to do and what not to do in our own devotional service, we are actually reconnecting with them. We are associating with them and reconnecting our consciousness with the whole process of devotional service through their inspiration. Okay. So studying Srimad Bhagavatam and going through the great pastimes of several great devotees is such an inspiring experience to everyone. So, when we are distributing books or spreading this whole message of Krishna consciousness, either by speaking or giving it in the form of book, we should maintain that pure intent. So the content that we are distributing is pure, and the intent with which we are doing so should also be pure. So when we are reading, we should read pure content with a pure intent. And when we are distributing also, we should distribute the pure content with the pure intent. Pure content is the authentic message of the scriptures as presented by bona fide representatives of Krishna. That is pure content. Pure intent is by doing so, by either by studying or by sharing what I have studied. The intent should be to revive our own connection with Krishna and not do something else. Okay, when we are giving Krishna consciousness to, when we are sharing Krishna consciousness with others, it's not that, oh, I am so great and I am able to connect so many people to Krishna. Not like that. A devotee considers oneself as a representative of Parampara and a humble servant and instrument in the hands of Parampara. Okay, we are supposed to be in representative consciousness, not replacement consciousness. Okay, we are supposed to be thinking of oneself to be instrument. Okay, so not, it's not just our accomplishment to connect people to Krishna consciousness, but it is done with a consciousness of being an instrument in the hands of the Parampara, right? So when one has that pure intent and presents pure content, then Krishna reciprocates with the sincerity that we have. So our responsibility is to study nicely and share it nicely. And how much we will be able to assimilate depends on how pure is our intention, how pure is our desire to be connected to Krishna and to connect few other people also to Krishna. So to that degree, and in by doing this, if we have other intentions of getting some name, fame, prestige, money, cheap adoration of people, public, fans, likes, this and that, then Krishna will see that, oh, this is what he wants. My God, it's not very pleasing to Krishna, right? What is pleasing to Krishna is when a devotee does whatever he does with a selfless intent. Ahituki apratihata. So, and Krishna reciprocates with that sincerity, right? So, a devotee is supposed to be an essence seeker and essence giver. So just like we saw, tadasya kausharava sharmadatur hareh kathameva kathasu saram, one should be seeking the essential message of scriptures and one should be sharing that essence. So only one who seeks essence can give essence. Right? Otherwise, there is so much of detail in the universal history, in the world history, in the national history, and in the universal history. So many events have happened, right? So our attempt to study scripture should not be an endeavor to gather more and more information, but actually aspire for transformation. So it's a transformation that we should be looking forward to and not the information. So now devotees are meant to be just sitting together and discuss Krishna Katha. Machitta madgata prana bodhayantaha parasparam kathayantascha mam nityam tushyanti charamanti cha. Machitta madgata prana. Devotees have dedicated their lives to Krishna consciousness, Krishna's thoughts, right? Prana, prana means life. So they cannot maintain their life without discussing Krishna Katha. And what do? Bodhayantaha parasparam. Mutually, they enlighten each other, they teach each other about Krishna. Kathayantascha maham nityam. On a regular basis, they do katha. Tushyanti cha ramanti cha. With great happiness and with great satisfaction of heart. And Krishna Katha is not just meant to be spoken in some public forums only, with a mic, with a sound system, with a Zoom call, with 100 people around, 1,000 people around. It's not necessarily so. Krishna Katha is best relished when we have that enthusiasm just to hear the glories of Krishna and speak the glories of Krishna, right? And it can be done in a small private conversation also. Two people. Now just 2 years we didn't come out for any yatra outing. So now in our ashram, few devotees are just coming out for yatra. Few like small groups, 5 people, 6 people, 7 people. They would just come out for a week. They would just go to some dham and then come back. So like that, 5 of us came for a small yatra for a week to Vrindavan. So what we are doing is 5 of us are sitting and then discussing Krishna Katha. One devotee is sharing something from Govardhan Lila. Another devotee is sharing something about the holy name. So like that, we are just doing some parikrama. We are just going to different spots. And just four or five of us are sitting here. And then sharing Krishna Katha. And when we hear another devotee speaking about Krishna, our appreciation for Krishna increases and our appreciation for that devotee also increases. Oh, this is how this devotee loves Krishna. Wow. So I should love him. Okay. So when we hear about Krishna from another devotee, that's a great opportunity for us to establish a good friendship and nice Vaishnava relationship with that person. And develop some appreciation for that person. How much he loves Krishna. So, and to that degree, we develop appreciation for him. So, Kunti Maharani says, a devotee is not one who is just eager to glorify Krishna. A devotee is one who also shows great eagerness to hear when others are glorifying Krishna. Very important point. Shrinvanti gayanti grananty abhikshnasah smaranti nandanti tavehitam janah tayeva pashyanti chirena tavakam bhava pravaho paramam padambujam. Shrinvanti, devotees hear about Krishna. Gayanti, they glorify Krishna, they sing about Krishna. Grananti abhikshnasah, constantly they accept this whole process of Krishna consciousness and they imbibe that spirit of Krishna consciousness and they apply the principles that they have learned from scriptures. Ranantya bhikshnachah. Smaranti, they remember Krishna. Nandanti tava ihitam janaha. When other devotees are glorifying Krishna, they relish that. They take great pleasure in that. So it's not that only I have to speak Krishna gatha or I have to sing the holy names, I have to do the lead the main kirtan in the maharti. Yeah, devotees may do that, definitely. But when others also are doing, a devotee becomes happy. So devotee genuinely becomes happy to see others also glorifying Krishna. Right? Of course, in an authentic way, bonafide way. So when we take pleasure in other devotees' advancement in Krishna consciousness, Krishna makes us also advance. So devotee has no envy towards other devotees, and devotee has great appreciation for other devotees. And a devotee really takes pleasure when others are doing wonderful service, right? And hear from them. So, parasparanu kathanam pavanam bhagavadyashah mithoratihi mithah tushtir nivrittir mitha atmanah paraspara anukathanam. Devotees glorify Krishna and enlighten each other in Krishna's glories. Paraspara means they sit together. Mutually, they increase their love for Krishna by discussing about Krishna. Pavanam bhagavadyashah, because they sit together and discuss Krishna katha, pavanam, that will completely purify their consciousness, because that is bhagavadyashah. Bhagavadyashah means glories of Krishna have the potency to transform our hearts. So, kathayantas mithorati himidha tushtir. Mithorati means one's rati, or one's attraction for Krishna increases. Mithaha tushtir. Tushti means satisfaction increases. Nivrittir mitha atmanaha. Okay. And one's material attractions will be completely destroyed. So, eimata duijana nana katha range Krishna katha asvadiya rahi eka sangi. Ramanandarai and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, only two people, sat for 10 days and they were discussing Krishna Katha. Only two people. It's not a big organized program where there are 1,000 people, right? He did not have a sound system. Ramanandarai did not have sound system. And he did not have so many audience also. Mahaprabhu is sitting there. Okay, Mahaprabhu is sitting and hearing and Ramanandarai is speaking. So from Mahaprabhu's perspective, you see, Mahaprabhu is playing the role of a devotee and is taking great pleasure when other devotee is glorifying Krishna. Right? Devotees are those people who take pleasure to see and to hear other devotees glorifying Krishna. Okay. Yes, they have enthusiasm to glorify Krishna, but they are also enthusiastic to hear glories of Krishna from other devotees also. So, like that, mutually they can become Krishna conscious. Right? सो भागवतम भगवद गीता चैतन्य चरितामृत ऑल दिस ग्रेट लिटरेचर्स आर गिविंग अस दिस रिपीटेड मैसेज प्लीज नरिश योरसेल्फ प्लीज एब्जॉर्ब योरसेल्फ इन हरिकथा एंड द स्क्रिप्चर्स आर द बेसिस वेयर डू वी गेट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट ऑल द पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ कृष्णा वेयर डू वी गेट ऑथेंटिक description of Krishna's nama rupa guna lila from the scriptures from Gita Bhagavatam sometimes when I am asked to speak about some glories of Krishna okay speak something about Krishna or speak something about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu if I have not studied what will I speak if I have not heard from bona fide sources what will I speak if I have not developed any appreciation for Krishna what will I speak about Krishna Right, so scriptures regularly hearing and studying scriptures will help us develop appreciation for Krishna. And when we are asked to share something about Krishna, then we will be able to speak out. Right. Otherwise, if the mind is filled with so many materialistic thoughts, still unfulfilled material desires, and more than this, grudge. Negative feelings towards other devotees. What will come out of the mouth? When I hold so much of negative feelings, negativity towards other people, when I open my mouth, that negativity only will come. When the mind is filled with positivity, appreciation for Krishna and his devotees, when I open my mouth, that will come out. Right? So, we can develop that positivity and appreciation for Krishna and his devotees and whole Vaishnavas to the degree we hear Bhagavatam from bona fide sources and we read Bhagavatam from bona fide commentaries and bona fide acharyas. Right? So to purify the contamination of envy, pride, greed and all other shortcomings in our minds, we need to replace all those negative thoughts with the positive vibrations of Krishna Katha, right? So actually, by discussing Krishna Katha amongst devotees, our friendships will increase. So many people may say, oh, how to develop good friendships amongst devotees? How do I get some Vaishnava friendships, relationships? The best way is to study Srimad Bhagavatam. What is the connection? I study Bhagavatam. And I develop friendship with that devotee. Yes, it is true. These are not my words. These are words of Bhagavatam. You know that popular shloka? Atma Ramascha Manayo Nirgrantha Apurukrami. First canto, 7th chapter, 10th shloka. Atma Ramascha Manayo Nirgrantha Apurukrami Kurvanti Ahaitukim Bhaktim Ittham Bhuta Guno Harihi. So, Krishna's qualities are so great that even great Atmaramas, Nirgranthas, Munis also get attracted to Krishna's qualities and Kurvanti Ahaitukim Bhaktim and they will perform unmotivated devotional service unto the Lord, being attracted by Krishna's qualities. I'm not going to elaborate on this beautiful shloka, very popular shloka, many of you must be knowing also, but I'm going to elaborate on the next shloka, which is very important in our current context discussion. The next shloka says, Harer gunakshipta matihim Bhagavan Badarayani Adhyagan Mahadakhyanam Nityam Vishnu Janapriyaham Harer gunakshipta matihi. The mati or the mind of a devotee here in this context, Sukadeva Goswami. The mind of Sukadeva Goswami is so absorbed and immersed in the qualities of Krishna. Harer guna akshipta matihi. Bhagavan Badarayanihi. So, Sukadeva Goswami could absorb his mind in the qualities of Krishna by hearing Bhagavatam. And Adhyagan Mahadakhyanam. And how exactly? Adhyagan, he did Adhyayan. He did study of what? Mahadakhyanam, this great narration of Srimad Bhagavatam. Sukadeva Goswami was just running away after his appearance. Then Vyasadeva Raya was running behind Sukadeva Goswami. Come back, my dear son, please come back. He did not come. Then Vyasadeva has selected some shlokas, important shlokas from Bhagavatam, and told his disciples, go and recite the shlokas. in front of my son. And his disciples took the shlokas and they went in front of Sukadeva Goswami and started reciting the shlokas. Then Sukadeva Goswami got attracted to these shlokas because these shlokas are describing Krishna's qualities. Harer Guna Akshuptamatihi. Sukadeva Goswami's mind has become completely captivated in the qualities of Krishna as described in the shlokas. And he asked the disciples, where are these shlokas from? Then they said, these shlokas are from Srimad Bhagavatam. And your father, Vyasadeva, is the author of Bhagavatam. Oh, really? Then Sukadeva Goswami came and he has heard entire Srimad Bhagavatam. He studied entire Srimad Bhagavatam from his father, Vyasadeva. Adhyagan Mahadakhyanam. And by studying Srimad Bhagavatam and by developing appreciation for Krishna's qualities, Sukadeva Goswami has become so dear to devotees. Nityam Vishnu Janapriyaha. Vishnu Jana means devotees. Vishnu Janapriyaha. So Sukadeva Goswami, by studying and hearing Bhagavatam from Vyasadeva and by studying and hearing Bhagavatam, he developed appreciation for Krishna's qualities. So his Bhagavatam study and appreciation for Krishna made him so dear to Vaishnavas, Vishnu Janas. And the Vishnu Janas became dear to him. So by studying Bhagavatam and developing appreciation for Krishna, we come closer to other devotees. We love other devotees and other devotees love us. To the degree we have attraction for Krishna, and the basis of that attraction is studying Srimad Bhagavatam. Right? This shloka is very emphatically saying that. You can go back and see this shloka, 1.7.11. Okay. So studying Srimad Bhagavatam is not an ordinary privilege. Hearing Srimad Bhagavatam is not an ordinary fortune. Right? So to stay in the association of devotees and hear Srimad Bhagavatam, study Srimad Bhagavatam, and make a humble, sincere attempt to apply the principles of Srimad Bhagavatam in one's own life is the greatest fortune that a conditioned soul can attain. By Prabhupada's grace, through Prabhupada's books, we all got this fortune. And we should be intelligent enough and diligent enough to utilize this opportunity and absorb ourselves in the sound vibration of Srimad Bhagavatam. And based with that foundation of understanding which is provided from Srimad Bhagavatam, we can do all our services. So we should serve. Of course, we should not just be sticking to, okay, I will study. Like, to become a scholar, to become very familiar with the shlokas of Bhagavatam. But actually, how much we have studied and how much we have understood, how much we have realized, how much we have assimilated Srimad Bhagavatam is demonstrated by how we render our services. Right? So, scholarship is an insignificant byproduct of Bhagavatam study. The end product is transformation of character and development of genuine service attitude and love for Krishna ultimately. Right? So, studying Srimad Bhagavatam is not an intellectual exercise. Bhagavatam is not understandable by one who has envy in the heart. Bhagavatam is understood by one who has purity of heart. To the degree, there is no envy, to that degree, one can relate with Srimad Bhagavatam. And as far as sharing the message of the scriptures is concerned, yes, we can share only to the degree we nourish ourselves. We should personally relish and we can share what we relish. We can personally study and appreciate, then we can share that appreciation. And somebody asks me, can you just speak something about Krishna? I don't know much. Oh, you don't know much because we have not sufficiently heard or studied. So we should be propositious. We should not be in an embarrassing situation when somebody asks. Of course, there are some technical questions that people may ask. We may not know everything. Knowing everything about Krishna is not possible and not practical. Even Krishna also doesn't know everything about him. What do we understand? But at least, to the best of our ability, we should understand the scriptures and and study Srimad Bhagavatam, hear Srimad Bhagavatam, develop our genuine appreciation for Krishna on the basis of scriptures. So like that, Bhagavatam gives us several inputs. Then as far as sharing is concerned, as I was just saying, one may not know everything to speak, but one can speak whatever one knows, as simple as that. Okay. Now you see, same Vidura speaks to Maitreya. Tathapi kirtayam yanga yatha mati yatha shrutam. Kirtim hareha swam satkartam giram anyabhidasatim. Maitreya Muni describes, this is spoken to Maitreya Muni, by the way. So Maitreya Muni speaks about the universal form of the Lord. And after speaking, he says, I don't know much. I don't understand the glories of Krishna so much. But still, tathapi kirtayami anga, still I make an attempt to glorify Krishna. Tathapi kirtayami anga. Why? How? Yatha mati yatha shrutam. Based on whatever I could hear from bona fide sources and based on whatever I could understand and assimilate from those, from that hearing, I'm able to speak. Right? So, kirtim hareh swam satkartam, by glorifying Krishna, swam satkartam, I am creating auspiciousness for myself only. So, who is the first person who is benefited when somebody speaks Krishna katha? Oneself. When I glorify Krishna, when I speak about Krishna, I am the first person to be benefited. Right? So, that need not be in a very big public forum. It can be a private conversation also. So, yathamati yathashrutam kirtim hareh swam satkartam giram anyabhidasatim. If I don't utilize my power of speech and glorifying Krishna, my power of speech will remain unchaste. Okay. So the chastity of speech is in engaging that speech in glorifying Krishna. Then the speech will remain chaste. Otherwise it's unchaste. Okay. So now, all our senses are dependent on the master of senses. Krishna is called Hrishikesha. Hrishikesha means master of senses. So, Hrishikena Hrishikesha Sevanam Bhakti Ruchyate. What is Bhakti? When the Hrishika, when our senses are engaged in the sense enjoyment of the master of senses, Krishna, and that is called Bhakti. As simple as that. Bhakti is to engage our senses in the service of the master of senses, Krishna. Hrishikena Hrishikesa Sevanam. And Prabhupada says, Sevan Mukhehi Jihvadau. First, one needs to engage the tongue in Krishna's service. Jihvadau Swayameva Spratyaka. Beginning with tongue. So glorify Krishna. Chant the holy names of Krishna. Right? So when we chant the holy name of Krishna, when we glorify Krishna, either Nama, Rupa, Guna, Leela, so that purifies our consciousness. There is a beautiful shloka. Alam 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 eka praninam patakanam nirasana vishayeva krishna krishneti vani yadi bhavati mukunde bhaktiranand sandra karatala kalita sa moksha samrajya lakshmi. Alam 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 eka praninam patakanam. Okay. So the Krishna Krishneti Vani, the two syllables Krish and Na, this name of Krishna, Krishna, when it is uttered, that sound vibration can completely chase away all the sinful reactions. Praninam patakanam nirasana vishayeva Krishna Krishneti Vani. Not just chasing the sinful reactions, yadi bhavati mukunde bhaktirananda sandra. By chanting the holy names, we are immersed in an ocean of happiness of bhakti. That's the end product. Going, removal of sinful reactions is just as a byproduct, right? Sukaratala kalita sa moksha samrajya lakshmi. Moksha samrajya lakshmi, the opulence of the kingdom of liberation will come into our hands. So like that, liberation becomes insignificant, removal of sinful reactions become insignificant when we chant the holy names of Krishna. So like that, Krishna Krishna's holy name or Krishna's pastimes, Krishna's qualities are a great source of nourishment and relish for all the devotees. So to the degree we are fortunate, to that degree we utilize this opportunity to chant the holy names. So a person who received this opportunity and instruction to chant the holy names and doesn't utilize that the opportunity is very unfortunate. So the greatest fortune is to engage oneself in hearing and chanting the holy names of the Lord, and also inspire others also to do so to the best of one's ability. So Prabhupada had spent sleepless nights to write these books. At least when we are awake, let's read. Let's not sleep while reading. So Prabhupada compromised on his sleep to write. Okay. And it's our responsibility to take advantage of what Prabhupada has given us, this great treasure. Okay, so Prabhupada was doing so much of management and constructing so many temples and inspiring so many people. Preaching is going on. So parallelly, so while so much of expansion is going on, parallelly has given so much emphasis on writing books in the silent hour of the night. In the middle of the night, he wouldn't sleep. He would write books. He would translate the Srimad Bhagavatam, because this is very, very important. This expansion is important. We will be able to expand to the degree we nourish our consciousness, right? When the happiness of studying Bhagavatam and nourishing oneself from oneself with the descriptions of Nama, Rupa, Guna, Leela of Krishna. So to the degree that enthusiasm and that absorption is overflowing and it comes out and it goes to everyone else. So with a shallow heart, with a heart which is not sufficiently filled with appreciation for Krishna's qualities, we cannot inculcate that appreciation in others. So we should nourish ourselves and we should also share that fortune with others also. So with these few words, I conclude the presentation. It's 8:13 now, 2 minutes. So thank you so much for giving me your blessings and your association and this opportunity to glorify Krishna. And I sincerely beg blessings from all of you so that I come to proper consciousness and maintain that proper consciousness of studying Prabhupada's books and engaging my services without any false pride and deviation. So thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Granthraya Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Any questions or comments?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you so much, Prabhuji, for wonderful discourse on encouraging all of us to read Bhagavatam and the consciousness with which you read Bhagavatam and the gratitude that you carry while we are reading Bhagavatam. So nicely explained by you, Prabhuji. And so many references you took from Dhruva Maharaj and Maitreya Muni conversation. So many things, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, I there is one comment I would like to make and one question that I would like to ask. Comment is, Prabhuji, sometimes feel so fortunate to be part of ISKCON society, because Prabhupada himself not only left his own Vani, but he created so many Vanis, you know, that we have so many different Prabhujis and Matajis, senior devotees around the world who are with the equal enthusiasm and equal amount of compassion. They are delivering such nice discourses. And we feel really fortunate to get all these senior devotees association folks, like you, visiting us once in a while and giving us the importance of reading Bhagavatam. And today, first time I heard about book distribution includes distribution outside, distribution inside. And that is a very heart-melting point of book distribution includes, spreading the message of Bhagavatam from inside. So I'd also like to tell Prabhuji that in our group, there are a few Bhagavatam study circles which we have started, and we are very successful so far. There is Prabhuji's name is Subbarao Prabhu. He is right now there in the call. So what he does is he assembles around 30 people, 30, 40, two times in a week on Tuesday and Thursday. and they all just read Bhagavatam in the circuit. They just keep every evening 2 hours, and I think they've crossed close to fourth canto at this point. And the enthusiasm is so much growing that even if one class is cancelled, he says that, you know, they call up and ask, you know, why is it cancelled? Why is it not happening? You know, we can't imagine a week going by without reading Bhagavatam.
Wow.
So there are many devotees in the satsang also who have reached 8th canto, 9th canto. They are going. So one is self-reading, and second is reading in a circle. On top of that, these morning sessions are also like motivating boosters, you know, for us to hear from senior devotees. So I'm very grateful for you that your association and the Senior Devotees Association, that is there's Radhesham Prabhu. Actually, today Radhesham Prabhu is visiting us. We have a DT welcoming ceremony, Dwarnitya DT welcoming ceremony, two families, Subbarao Prabhu and Shilpa Mataji's family. Two families are becoming DTs. So we are all preparing for the big evening today. And it also happens to be Radhesham Prabhu's birthday. That's what I heard today. So I don't know, he doesn't like to be celebrated, but we're so happy that he is coming and giving his time to all of us. And today morning, you have given such a nice discourse. It's all happening for a good reason. Without any pride or any ask for any recognition, I just wanted to share that year on year, devotees in our satsang, they are very enthusiastic in distributing Srimad Bhagavatam also. And this year, with all efforts, everybody together, we distributed close to 242 Bhagavatam sets to many, many. And one of the missions that we have is to distribute Bhagavatam to temples. So Sri Vaishnava temples, they're distributing a lot of Bhagavatam. So far, I think close to 200 temples were distributed. And we are encouraging the pujaris to read Bhagavatam in their own temples. So that when anybody comes, they also hear some Bhagavatam. And some of them already started reading Bhagavatam. And they have so much told thanks to many of the devotees who sponsored such Bhagavatam sets. So again, all glories to devotees like your grace who are always encouraging everybody to do their part. To be constantly in touch with God. So probably the question that I have is, yeah. Hare Krishna?
I don't know if my internet is, it's for everyone. Yes, Prabhu.
Sorry.
Your voice is breaking few seconds.
I think there is a problem with your info signal. Hare Krishna, is anybody experiencing problem when I'm speaking?
I'm able to hear you properly, Lilan Prabhuji.
Voice is a little bit low, Prabhu. Your voice is a little bit low.
No, Prabhuji, your voice is fine. It's not breaking for us. It's fine, Prabhu.
It's not breaking.
Maybe my internet is poor.
Yeah, Dwaran Darshan Prabhu's internet also was absolutely fine till now.
Just now.
Yeah. So, Prabhuji, the question that I have is, many times while devotees are reading Bhagavatam, you know, there are some very technical sections that come, whereby there is a lot of discussion about creation, about the expansion. And I shouldn't use the word boring, but, you know, sometimes it becomes very difficult to focus and go through those sections, you know, with the same amount of enthusiasm. We are like, okay, let this section get over fast. Let this section get over fast. You know, because we're not able to connect to it. So what is the consciousness one should carry when we are going through such sections?
Yes. One thing is, am I audible clearly?
Yes.
Like my internet is poor. So yes, there are some technical sections. It's very austere for some devotees to go through those sections, especially the fifth canto, universal cosmology, and even the teachings of Jada Bharat to Rahugana, and especially second canto, the whole manifestation of creation. And even third canto, teachings of Lord Kapila. 11th canto, Uddhava Gita. So, there are quite a few sections in Bhagavatam. They are very philosophical, very technical, and they are very appealing to people who are very intellectual. But simple readers, average readers, may find them very tough to digest. Nimi Navayogindra Samvad in the 11th canto. And even a few sections in the 12th canto. So now, Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe Yuktam Vairagyam Uchyate. So anything that is connected to Krishna can be accepted. The entire Bhagavatam is non-different from Krishna. One needs to you know, respect every section. However, understanding one's own bandwidth, right? One may not be very intellectual, or one may not be able to digest certain sections. They may find not that they have disrespect for those sections, but they themselves do not have that bandwidth or intellectual capabilities to understand. So one way to approach those sections is to approach a devotee who can explain those sections nicely. In our personal study, we may not be able to easily follow them. But when we go to some experienced devotees who understood them properly, and they will be able to explain to us. So that's one way. That's a very important way. Secondly, like when we read entire Bhagavatam, some sections are especially appealing to us. It's not wrong to give more preference to them or just dwell more on them. Okay, now I may read all 12 cantos, but the story of Parikshit Maharaj is extremely inspiring to me. Or the story of Dhruva Maharaj, or Prahlad Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj is my favorite. Okay, or like Krishna Leela a lot, 10th canto, Vrindavan pastimes. Or some devotees like Narasimhadev's pastimes a lot. And some people like that Bharat Maharaj, very instructive. So now Bhagavatam has variety of pastimes. Okay. Some sections manifest Krishna's sweetness so nicely. Some sections manifest Krishna's greatness so nicely. Some sections are describing those pastimes of Krishna's devotees. And some sections are describing the pastimes of Krishna's incarnations. So depending on one's own current situation and one's own level of advancement and one's taste, some sections are appealing to some people. And it's not wrong. Because some children are there. You can't just speak directly universal cosmology to them. You speak Prahlad's story, they'll hear nicely. You speak Dhruva's story, they'll hear happily. You speak Krishna's childhood pastimes, they will hear so nicely. Okay. So it's definitely for a grown-up adult, serious practitioner, devotee, yes, what is recommended is read Bhagavatam cover to cover. That we have to always respect that advice. Okay. But once you have read completely Bhagavatam cover to cover, although it is austere, sometimes you take help from other devotees, support from other devotees, and hear their explanations to understand certain sections. So somehow you completed the Bhagavatam. But definitely there are some sections that are very dear to your heart. You can read them repeatedly. You can speak on them repeatedly. It's not anything objectionable. Mm-hmm. So like Prabhupada, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he used to hear Dhruva and Prahalad repeatedly, hundreds of times, right? So yes, we can dwell on our favorite sections, but it's also a part of our sadhana to read Bhagavatam cover to cover, and whichever section is difficult, we can take help from other people for experience. Makes sense, Prabhu?
Oh, yes. Thank you. Thanks, Prabhu. Really helpful. Yeah. Can we take one more question, Prabhu? Is it okay for you?
Yes, Prabhu. 8:30, I have a class. I have 6 more minutes. So okay, you can ask the next
There's
question.
No break for you then. Just one more question from anyone. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Danda Prana. Prabhuji, you talked about sadhana and purity in ourselves, and also you talked about service. Devotional service rendered, and it also covers preaching and many other aspects. So how to balance these two? If we are focused on service, then obviously our sadhana somehow gets affected. I feel that because we are not at that pure stage where we can understand, okay, our sadhana is also our service and our service is also sadhana. So for a neophyte devotee like us, can you please guide practically?
Also neophyte only. The point is, we don't have to be passive. Am I audible? Everything got stuck for me.
We lost your video.
Hare Krishna, am I audible now?
You're back.
So, I was saying, we don't have to be passionate. So we need to cultivate goodness. And from goodness, we can transcend the material modes and
Raji, your audio and video is stuck. Can you switch off your video? Can you switch off your video so that we can hear you, Prabhuji?
Yes, that's better. Okay. Am I audible now?
Yeah.
Yes.
So, yes. What I was saying is, yes, sadhana requires some time and service also requires some time. And yes, both are same. Sadhana is also service and service is also one sadhana. Okay. So there is overlap between these two. They are non-different in one sense. At the same time, we should also understand that we should give some exclusive time for our hearing and chanting. And service involves a lot of dealing with matter, with a lot of people. When our sadhana is not proper, when our chanting of rounds is not proper, when our study is not proper, when our hearing is not proper, then that lack of that absorption in sadhana is reflected in our services. Services will get affected. Because while doing services, one could become passionate. Of course, service is transcendental if it is done to Krishna with a sincere heart. But there's a lot of dealing with matter. So for us to render that service in a proper consciousness, we need to observe ourselves in sadhana nicely. Okay. So for that, we need to spare like good quality of time in doing our sadhana also, early in the morning, especially if we complete our rounds early in the morning. Throughout the day, we can focus on our service. But if we have rounds left, and the 16 rounds, whatever 1.5 hour, 2 hours it may take, if that 16 rounds times that 2 hours, if you just spread over 24 hours, okay, 10 minutes now, 15 minutes there, and you know, half an hour in the lunch break, and then 10 more minutes in the evening. So if you spread throughout, so we are neither doing the service properly nor sadhana properly. Of course, there are some busy phases. The Janmashtami is coming, Radhashtami is coming, a book distribution, marathon. There are some busy phases in a year. So it's understandable that in those busy phases, we may not be able to read for a few days. We may not be able to give quality time to certain elements, all the elements of morning program and all. It's understandable, it's circumstantial. But that kind of thing should not be 365 days. Okay. Janmashtami is coming, that 1 week we are very busy with arrangements, but it should not be on a daily basis. Okay. So yatra. So in yatra, say 10 days yatra, and you have to facilitate the yatra of 1,000 devotees, and you are too busy. That's fine. But there are several devotees who get up early in the morning and complete their rounds nicely. That 1.5 hours, they will not allow anything else to bother them. And then remaining 22 hours, okay, do service like that. So it's more than time management. It is priority management. If we prioritize our sadhana nicely, then we naturally give that time to that sadhana. And service will follow. Okay. Makes sense, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Yes, Prabhu. Thank you very much.
That is all. Thanks. His grace, Gaurang Darshan Prabhu. Three loud and enthusiastic. Hari Bo.
Hari Bo. Hari Bo. Hari Bo. Hari Bo.
Thank you so much, Lilanand Prabhu, for your kindness and affection. Although I'm quite younger to you, you are very humble. So thank you so much for your association. It's a pleasure for me also to speak Krishna Katha in the midst of so many sincere devotees. I'm also very happy to hear that all of you are regularly reading Bhagavatam. Your Nanda missing is like you remind it, you feel that absence. So very, very happy to hear this. Thank you so much.
While you all are dropping off, quick reminder, today evening we have a big festival. It's welcoming Gaur Nithai into our hearts, into our homes. Even if you have Gaur Nithai deities in your home, it's your own deities coming back again into your life. So it's a special of the family. So please come early. Please take up services. Come as soon as you can, 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock. I'm sure many have already taken up services. But try your best to come early. I'm personally asking for excuse. I'm running behind patients. I might not be able to come early. And today is also birthday of Radhesham Prabhu.
Haribol!
Don't bring a cake. Prabhuji doesn't like a cake. Once I did that, he chastised me in such a way that 2 years I couldn't forget. So don't do that. No cake cutting.
Prabhu, we are otherwise planning on getting a cake, so we should drop that. No,
please.
Nobody's birthday party. Nobody's.
You can bring a cake, but don't tell happy birthday and cake. No, no. Like it.
So what do we do for birthday?
Yeah, birthday, I think. We should look at what the devotee likes.
Right.
That's the most important thing. At this point, Prabhuji is all about book distribution.
Book distribution.
That's all it is, right?
So
if we all can impress him by sponsoring Bhagavad Gita boxes on his name, he'll be very happy. You can tell on the occasion of your birthday, you have distributed 25,000 Bhagavad Gita's today. Just kidding, not 25,000, but whatever that we can, 1 box, 2 box, 3 box, each family. We can. I'll put an auction there. And everybody can start telling 1 box, 10 box, 5 box, whatever. Right? And we'll distribute it in the village as well, but in the name of Prabhuji's birthday. So, Krishna gives him a long life and keeps him pressing. That's my proposal. I mean, it's up to you, whatever else that you. So, that is what Prabhuji likes. Sadhu likes. Because Sadhu doesn't like anything like material. He only likes. So anyway, we
cannot. No.
My wife is re-insisting and iterating and making it
Prabhuji,
clear.
Prabhuji, as you said, let's put a sign-up sheet and let's have some people sign up and then encourage others to sign up to sponsor Bhagavad Gita sets, books.
Yeah, we'll do an auction. 5-minute auction. Right?
Yes, but
so, how many are sponsoring? Who are wants to sponsor? I think 1 box is what, Subhara Prabhu? English set box is
3,600. Yeah, Telugu is 3,000.
Telugu set is 3,000.
3,000, right? So let people sponsor the boxes. You know, we'll get them.
So yeah, Prabhu, we'll plan it, Prabhu. We'll do that. Yeah, we'll work it out.
And that is like a offering for on the occasion of Prabhu's birthday. You know, we all want to do it.
Yes, Prabhu. Yes, Prabhu.
Is it okay?
Please target today.
Hari Bol.
Today you need to hit the target.
Yes. I mean, whatever little we do, you know, we might just hit 1,000. That's okay. Still, you did something.
Yeah. Why just 1,000?
So,
yes, Prabhu. We'll do more than that, Prabhu.
Subhara Prabhu, any services? Shilpa Mataji, I don't know if she's on the call, but any services where you're still struggling?
No, Prabhu, I think we need, if somebody can, I mean, people can come early, like, you know, 3 o'clock or something. We might need some help during decoration and, you know, keeping the hall, that's all. I'm only, and then everybody's prayers that the rain should not be there at the time of the program.
Don't worry, we'll take care of Indra. Tell me.
It's not raining too much here, at least, Prabhu. It's okay.
Yeah, it's a little bit drizzle. So, you know, dinner is normally outside. So, that's one thing you should worry.
Yeah.
Worst case, can we do it inside?
Yes, Prabhu, we can do it inside. That is, worst case, we can do it in the cafeteria.
So, who is going to pick up Radhesham Prabhu?
Prabhu, I'm going.
Okay. Because you'll get 1.5 hours of association.
Yeah, Prabhu, I'm going.
Yes, yes, wonderful. And who is dropping, Prabhuji?
Mahesh Prabhu is dropping.
Mahesh Prabhu is dropping. Very, very, very nice. Yeah, anybody else who wants to join them also, please. But you know, we need many more services here. So let's equally. And anything else, Prabhuji? Anything else?
The hall decoration and stuff, that's the only thing that's there, Prabhu. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Surendra Prabhu is taking care of the books, and we got about 100 books today for distribution and stuff.
Yeah, and the school principal.
Yes, I spoke to him, he's coming. So we're giving him one Bhagavatam set and Bhagavad Gita books, one box basically.
Okay.
And if you think we need more,
if you can make a list of it, you know, I can announce.
Yes.
A certain time. When do you think we should do it? Right after Prabhuji's lecture, right?
Yes.
Or we should do it before Prabhuji's lecture.
After
Okay. After Prabhuji's lecture. My request to all the devotees to not come and make Prabhuji wait. So let's all be there, nicely doing Sankirtan before Prabhuji comes. So that it's a glorious day today. We have many senior devotees coming today, including Radhisham Prabhu. Balguin Prabhu is also going to be there. He's himself performing the Abhishekam and the DT welcoming. And there are, I think, Shyam Bihari Prabhu has also joined. Very senior
devotee. Yes, he's joining.
Yes. And so green grace is becoming God's grace day by day. So we have many, many, many devotees who are coming. And mine,
so,
yeah. Yes, Prabhu. Any other services?
We are going to have like about 50 people from Green Grace, Prabhu. At least 50 people have confirmed, but more than that, at least 70 people. Then altogether, we should be around 250. The counts, people come as per the counts, basically.
How are we managing small children, especially small children, so if they're not disturbed? We should have some space behind so that maybe if we can get some color printouts and some crayons in advance so that small children, you know, like below 7 years.
We'll handle it, Prabhuji.
Prabhuji, there is a place when you enter the hall on the right side, where we do it. So I'm going to get the printouts. So tomorrow we'll have the kids' corner.
Yeah, we can arrange that place, Prabhu. Not the hall, but there's a room next to the hall behind the reception area.
Yeah.
You can use that room, Prabhu. That's where we are putting
it. I don't want any devotee to miss the whole occasion. I mean, in the case. So, you're saying some corner area in the hall, in the back side, so we can take the small children there and put them to.
That's very convenient for us to manage, but what if there is a noise, Prabhuji? That's the only problem. I mean,
yeah.
We'll see.
In the hall, probably there might not be much place, Prabhu.
Okay. Let us see. See the book distribution, the book table area, right? On the right side, right after into the hall, left side. That corner also, we can make the children sit down and do it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let us try to keep it within the hall because I don't want any few devotees to miss the whole class, engaging the devotees and festival for everyone. And the children
yes,
also.
Prabhuji, kids, yes, Prabhuji, if the kids will be in the hall, it will be better.
Yeah. So let's. I have a lot of color. Can somebody take the task of getting a lot of papers, like 50, 40 of them in which and crayons? We'll sit down and do it.
Prabhuji, I'll get the printouts and whatever crayons we have at home.
Crayons I'll get, Prabhu. Crayons yeah. I can get. Printouts if you can get to somebody. Then.
I'll get the printouts. I have a lot of used crayons at home in the big box. I'll get it also.
And if any devotee is going to Abbot's temple, we can get a garland from Abbot's temple for Prabhuji.
Oh.
Prabhupada garland. If any devotee is coming through, I would say.
No,
Prabhuji, how about getting it from the Rampalli temple? I'm going there, no? Abbots, I'm not going, but I'm going to the Rampalli center, right?
Then you should call Madhav Gopinath Prabhu and tell in advance that you need a garland.
Okay.
Prabhuji, I'll pick him up from the Rampalli center only, right?
Yes. I'll talk. Yes, Prabhu. Yes, you're picking up from Rampalli center. You're picking up.
Prabhuji, call him and tell him that we need a garland or
yes.
like if you want
yes.
to buy.
Yes.
So we don't want to buy that garland that's still on the streets with all the plastic threads and doesn't look good. Should be prepared and offered to Prabhupada. But if anybody is going to Abbot's temple, you can definitely go and ask the pujari there and ask for a jhan and then do it. If anybody is coming through that area also, you can stop by and ask. It'd be nice. Probably birthday also, it'd be nice offering. To give him maha garland. Yeah? Any other thoughts?
Yeah, just finish the class and go to Subhra Prabhuji's house for service. That's it.
Very good. Yes. So let's all have a wonderful festival today. And please, as many new devotees, just to see how jubilant our festivals are. And let's all have a great time. I hope that I really hope that I'll show this class recording to my father also when he recovers. He'll be very eager to see the festival also.
Yeah.
So let's have the recording done. I'm planning to keep my YouTube channel on live streaming. I think somebody else is doing Zoom. That should be good enough, right? And if you have some devotees who can take small clips of videos, you can join them and make it easier. I can take the responsibility for making a video.
Leelan Prabhu, do we need a project a screen?
Yes, we are making it standard.
Yeah, better to keep it. And Prabhuji brings a Mac, so try to have an add-on.
Which can Prabhuji, yes. The Mac.
What is that, Prabhu?
Connector. I'll get the connector, Prabhuji. I have
Mac
it. The
connector.
USB-C connector.
Mac yeah. Connector.
Mac. Apple Mac.
Oh, he bring his laptop, right?
Yeah, he might. He might suddenly use his laptop. So we'll give our laptop also.
Right.
Okay. So, Hari Bol. Did I go, Premanand?
Hari Bol.
Send out something.